Pfeiffer Me presents coverage of Planet Comic-Con 2017.
We are joined right now by Erica Williams, and she's actually here to talk to us about something pretty important, not only just in genre, but also in life these days. So, Erica, what would you like to talk with us about today?
Actually, today I'm here to represent the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention, as I am one of the board members of the Greater Kansas Chapter. And so it just kind of touches the lives of a lot of people that come to things like this that I know that I connect with very well.
Mm-hmm. That's certain. I think a lot of times we've seen people who reach out and cling on to genre things because they see sort of darker themes that they associate with. So, yeah, is that something that you tend to see when you go to these events and maybe people who would profit from a little bit of that outreach?
Absolutely. And it's not maybe it touches their dark side or just a different side of them. Maybe it's that lighter side they don't get that part of, or maybe that they see in their life. So they get to connect with something where maybe they don't feel like they can other places.
Awesome. That's fantastic that you guys are doing that. So tell me a little bit about AFSP and sort of what led you to this organization.
Absolutely. AFSP, the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention, is the number one nonprofit organization to get grants out for research for suicide prevention, which is really important. And we have field advocates that go to legislators to talk about mental health bills and suicide prevention bills to try to get that going. And right now we're in our 30th year to do that.
Wow.
So that's really exciting. And I got started with it just a couple years ago. I did my first Out of the Darkness community walk back in 2014, and that's where I have lived experience, and I suffer from depression. I'm okay saying that now. And but that was just, it's such a group that can hang on. They understand, or they want to understand, and it's a very loving group. And so it's something I'm able to be a part of, and I was invited to be on the board, and I'm excited to be able to help represent that.
Well, we certainly appreciate it. And actually, as someone else who has suffered from depression and very recently had a major depressive episode, I appreciate all the information that's out there and the sort of things that your organizations do. So tell me a little bit about suicide prevention awareness. What kind of things do you do specifically to raise awareness for that?
Absolutely. One of the things that we do, absolutely, like I talked about, is the walks. Mm-hmm. And on these walks, even though they're fundraising events, we just like to be able to bring people together in that kind of realm and to be able to share stories and that kind of thing. We do different events, and we do lots of table kind of things at different, whether it's a convention or a fair or health fairs. And we also do talks. We have one out called Talk Saves Lives right now. So we go out and do these programs, and we have More Than Sad that could be shared with schools or churches or any of these organizations that have, whether it's youth or adults, that just need to have a better understanding of what's going on, or maybe reaching out to those that might be struggling to know that they're not alone, that they really are going to be okay.
In terms of goals for the goals for your organization and whatnot, do you guys have any sort of statistical tenable goals that you're working towards?
Absolutely. Right now, like I said, AFSP is in its 30th year. We've got a lofty goal right now, and but we think it's attainable as long as we can get everybody on board. And we are trying to reduce suicide 20% by 2025.
Wow.
So that is lofty, but we do think that we can reach that as we get education and resources out there.
Are there often community events? Or, I mean, I know I've personally heard of them, but like I said before, I've struggled with depression myself, so I'm maybe a little bit more aware of it than somebody who might not have reached out for help yet thus
far. Absolutely. And like I said, the walks are a perfect one. Mm-hmm. And we do campus walks in the spring, usually our community walks, and they happen all across the nation. So we have the community walks in the fall, like I said, campus walks, so it reaches some of the college students who tend to struggle a lot in that kind of time.
Right, as they're leaving home.
Leaving home, finals, all the stress, that kind of thing. And then all kinds of other events. Some have all kinds of big galas, or, you know, we have a motorcycle ride that's coming up that's to silence the stigma. Mm-hmm. And that's coming up June 24th, and so motorcycle riders can go out and help do that, because a lot of them have lost somebody to suicide and we're right for them.
Absolutely. Now, I had a personal question from my standpoint as well. As some of our viewers and fans know, I work in a high school, and recently Netflix came out with a Netflix original based off of a book called 13 Reasons Why. I'm sure you're very familiar with it.
Yes.
We've had a couple meetings with our counselors with the students about, you know, the impact that this has. How have you guys changed the dialogue, or what is there that families and parents can reach out to you for in terms of information on this show? Because I know it's far reaching.
Absolutely. Actually, if you go to afspkc.com or afsp.org, you can get some information on how to talk to the teens, especially that maybe aren't telling their parents necessarily that they're watching it, because a lot of them have their own accounts, or if even with parents who are going to watch it with their teens or adults that are watching it on their own, it can be very triggering. Mm-hmm. And so it's just, you got to have the information of the very graphicness of the show and what it covers, and just know that if you're very vulnerable to watch that, it's okay that you don't have to watch it, you know, just because it's the trendy thing to do, but know that people out there are watching it and it is affecting people. Some have gotten very good information from it, and mm-hmm. others have had a lot of issues with it. So it's very controversial right now, but it's kind of riding that line. But I think it could have good information for those who don't understand what those of us go through or have been through with that.
Excellent. All right. I'm certainly going to be looking that up and sending it to my counselor. Are there any statistics that you'd like to specifically share? Any good news on the home front?
Wish I could. I hope that we can get better with this. Right now, Missouri is 18th on the list of above the national average of suicides. So we have twice as many suicides in Missouri than we do homicides. On the Kansas side, it's four times as many than a homicide. And it's pretty shocking, even though Kansas is 21st on the list.
Uh-huh.
So we've got a lot of work to do.
Yeah.
And a lot of people talk about the veterans, you know, we're losing 21 a day. And it's not just the ones that have been who are gone now. Mm-hmm. It's ones who are, you know, Vietnam vets and Korean vets and, you know, those who have been through a lot of different, you know, combat and
through
all
the ringer,
you know,
socially.
So that's a pretty general average. So we're trying to raise that up, and that's where we're trying to get that lowered, hopefully. And this is one of those ways to do it, is being able to connect with people, let them know they're not alone in their struggles.
Well, hopefully this is going to make a big impact. I'm sure that, anytime you guys hit the community, I know that at least one person is going to look at it and be like, maybe I should talk to someone. Maybe I should do something. If you guys know of anyone who you think might be struggling with depression or suicidal thoughts, reach out to them. Tell them that you're there for them. It's also important to know, if you are having problems, the Suicide Prevention Hotline has a text line. It was major for me when I was going through a depression episode and I didn't want to talk to anybody. Also, you can reach out to Erica Williams Foundation. Can you give us that website again?
Absolutely. It's afspkc.com for the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention of Greater Kansas, which covers 11 counties in Missouri also.
All right. Well, thank you very much for your time. I'm certainly very grateful for the outreach work that you guys have been doing. So thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you.
Bye.